Alright, what's going on? Homo Clover Finder here, and today we're gonna be playing some more Killing Flora 2. But yeah, you probably read from the title, or saw from the thumbnail, or just heard me saying something in the previous episode on how I'm gonna be playing with the Homo Clover today. So yeah, that's exactly what we're gonna be doing. We're gonna be checking out the Homo Clover, and I'm just gonna give like my opinions on it and say for which perk it's actually better. And just a little bit of a hint, I'm already playing that perk. Alright, just before we hop right into the video, I do want to give a little bit of a shoutout to Furko08 for pledging $10 over on the Patreon. So yeah, Furko, really appreciate that shit and thank you very much for that support. And Furko, on top of that, you get the Strasser thumbs up, you get the Strasser with the balloon, and you get the Strasser with the beer. Thank you very much. But yeah, again, thanks to each and every one of you who are still supporting me over on the Patreon, because without you guys, yeah, rest in pieces, YouTube. But since you guys still support me, I guess YouTube is not gonna be a ripperoni anytime soon, so thank you guys very much. And now let's continue with the video. So yeah, just gonna be playing today's Team Fortress, because this thing is still new, and yeah, let's see what we can actually do. Get it? New? Do? Kind of like rhymes a little bit. So yeah, the Homo Clover, or as I like to call it, the Homo Clover. I mean, it is a fantastic freaking weapon. I mean, it's more of a fantastic weapon for, you know, the Berserker than for the Medic, because I mean, in my eyes, the Medic should, you know, just heal at range. Just don't, like, engage any Zeds and shit like that. I mean, if he absolutely has to, then by all means, go for it. But I mean, the Medic's main priority is to heal and keep the team, you know, on its feet. If the team actually has a medic, because the team can do perfectly well without the medic. Because if people were actually smart, yeah, you can buy something at the trader called, you know, an HM Tech 101 pistol, and every single perk can have that shit, probably. Because that pistol only weighs 1 kilogram, and I mean, usually with perks you can still have 1 kilogram. You know, a free space, so just, you know, buy that shit. Well, then wave 1, 4 more dudes, and let's see what they are. Oh, Pego. Nice, and a Puke. I just like the Spagos, man. They're just, like, so fantastic. I mean, look at them. I mean, what's he doing, even? Will be missed. So, yeah, the Homo Clover only weighs 4 kilograms, I do believe. Let's just go and quickly check that shit out. And it does. So, this means you can have this thing for the Berserker, and you can also have something like, I don't know, the Badlax, Bone Crusher, Eviscerator. And on top of that, you can also upgrade this thing once if you have the Badlax, or you can, you know, upgrade this thing once and upgrade, you know, these things once. So, yeah, overall, if Tripwire don't do anything, you know, different to this weapon, yeah, I think it's gonna be pretty freaking good. But I mean, knowing Tripwire, yeah, when something's like relatively good, you just go and like nerf it to the ground. And then they like buff it a year later, you know, just like the Husk Cannon. But yeah, the next video I'm gonna be doing is probably going to be on the Husk Cannon, because that thing nowadays is, I mean, it's just a beast. Just nothing else to say about it. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, yeah, they pretty much buffed it, you know, in regards to how fast it fires. So yeah, that is pretty freaking good. Okay, let's just go quickly parry something. And I completely missed everything for some reason. But I mean, everything is still pretty dead. Is that a Skrake? It is. Well, then Clown will be missed. Oh, there's like a lot of things. Time to do this attack. And just like kill everything in 3 seconds. Okay, let me just go quickly while the door. Just like that. Pico, give me that free parry. Thank you very much. Oh, Puke. Nice. And now let's go back to door welding, because this is very freaking useful if you get a lot of Zeds at once. Okay, Pskrake, I know we had our differences, but I mean, why are you mad? I mean, what's he doing even? Yeah, that's right, sit down. And this dude. Okay, free ammunition, don't mind if I do, just gonna like go and step on your asses. And just do this. Yep, it's safe to say this thing is pretty good. And I know a lot of people are gonna be like, but Patafunder, why you always play solo, yeah? But I mean, trust me when I say this, I did play a lot of multiplayer, both with the Berserker and the Homo Clover, and the Medic with the Homo Clover, and for me, personally, like I said, since this video is pretty much like my opinion, yeah, it's way freaking better for the Berserker. Not even gonna lie. So yeah, the only bug I do have with this weapon is that if you sprint and want to do like a light attack, yeah, he's not even gonna attack. I mean, you can do it with the, you know, heavy attack, but with the light attack, doesn't work. Well, then autofill everything and upgrade this thing once, because why the hell not, and skip the Trotter. I mean, look at this thing, man. Okay, so something worth mentioning is that this thing is very similar to the Pulverizer. And by similar, I mean it is pretty much dead, but instead of like exploding Zeds, you actually heal yourself and poison the other Zeds. So if you ask me, is this thing better than the Pulverizer, I'm gonna say 100% freaking, because the Pulverizer, I mean, it was never like a weapon for me, man, it was just not that good. Okay, time to whoop these guys, easy, easy. I mean, look at this thing, man. I mean, it does seem a little bit overpowered in solo play, but in multiplayer, I mean, I can assure you it's the same freaking thing, because I still don't understand why people think multiplayer is all that different. I mean, fair enough, some Zeds have a little bit more health, but the only ones you actually see that have more health are, you know, the big ones. Okay, quarter pound, you're gonna die anytime soon. There we go. And here we have some good old-fashioned Pegos just falling down the stairs. Oh, and here we have an actual flesh pound. Let's just go and quickly rage and parry this dude, if I can. And keep on running away, I guess. Okay, spider, away you go. And I'll just go and homo clobber the big dudes, because that's what we're here for. Easy. But yeah, man, the heavy attacks, I'm kind of like using them a lot here because it's like solo and I don't even care how I play on solo because, I mean, there's like no one to carry besides myself. But I mean, in multiplayer, yeah, if you just keep doing, you know, light attacks, just like whooping everything, and if you absolutely, you know, need to do a heavy attack, you do it. Okay, that's a Skrake. Let's just go reload it really quick. Maybe EMP him, because that's something you can do. Wait, was he there? Alright, man, and now you're gonna die. How does it feel? Okay, I should probably just like parry something. There we go. Just like poison everything up. Kill some dudes. And easy. Nice. But yeah, man, overall, the Hemoclobber, very freaking good for the Berserker, but a little bit questionable on the Medic. I mean, I still do believe the Chirp War just like made, you know, a medic weapon as a Berserker weapon for the Berserker, if that made any sense. So yeah, this is what I mean. You can have the Badlaxe, which is like the most powerful weapon for the Berserker, and you can still have the Hemoclobber. No, and right off the bat, we're getting a lot of flesh bones, and one is already raged. Would you know it? Ow. Fam. Ow. 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 I mean, these flesh bones just don't even care, man. I mean, what are they doing? I mean, this is why I like the Berserker, just a freaking tank. Even though I'm just like missing some parries, but should I care? Ah, probably not. I mean, as long as I don't get like cornered from behind, we should be good to go. So yeah, since I took like a lot of damage from the flesh bones, I guess I'm just gonna go and I know heal myself with the Hemoclobber. But yeah, this is why I do believe this thing is just like the best, man. I mean, you just go in, you kill things with, you know, the Badlaxe, and if things get a little bit hairy, you just go a little bit backwards and just chop him with this thing. And it's GG and easy. Okay, Husks, what are your plans? Should I care? I mean, theoretically I should, but I don't. Okay, since I'm playing, like, I know the Berserker and shit like that, I might as well just, like, explain, you know, his grenades a little bit. You know, the EMP grenades. Because I do see a lot of Berserkers just like misusing these grenades. Because with the EMPs, yeah, you're just gonna like temporarily, you know, immobilize the Zed, if that makes any sense. I mean, not if he's like raged. Unless it's like a Skrake, but if a Fleshbone is raged, yeah, the EMP is not gonna do jack shit to him. I mean, the easiest way to put this is, you know, EMPing some husks or something, because they can't like shoot if you EMP him. Okay, what are you doing? I mean, I just like the bad luck, just like the most satisfying thing ever, but let's just go and use the homo clobber a little bit. And I'm just gonna like parry these dudes and quickly whoop them with the axe. But I mean, they just like all went sideways for some reason and I'm dying just a little bit. But I mean, should I care? And now we only have two more Zeds. And one's a Pukey. Alright, man. And the last one's gonna be a Figaro.
No point in saving, ladies and gents. The fat lady is singing.
Okay, she just went cross map. Well, then to the trader we go, and for the bosses, I always like to use the Wiz Trader, and you can either agree or disagree, but this thing is actually a beast for the bosses. Well then, and here we go. Okay, who's gonna be the boss? Please give me an abomination, patriarch, just anything but Hans. Oh yes, man. And his camera's still bugged. Nice. Bon appetit, indeed. Well, and here we have him, and this is why I like the Awis Raider, because you just don't even need to go near him, and you still do, like, a lot of damage. And to the people saying that the Awis Raider is bad, I mean, just going stand in a corner, man. You don't even know what the hell this thing is. Okay, I am gonna admit, it's not like the best for, you know, in-between waves. Because, you know, it has like limited ammo and not that much damage for the big Zeds. But it's still pretty freaking viable. So yeah, I don't understand the hate for the Oistrader. I still freaking like it. I mean, fair enough, we got like nerfed a couple of updates back. But, I mean, it's still pretty good. Okay, can I just like homo clobber your ass? I mean, I can just like heal and punch you at the same time. I mean, I'm not even healing, so I'm just gonna back up a little bit and whoop you right now. Abomination, everyone. Hardest boss in the game. I mean, I do like his design, though. He's like a huge freaking clown. Okay, I just realized that this thing has the same sounds as the baseball bat. Or should I say the Road Redeemer? The freaking battle scarred bullpup, yeah, thanks, man. So yeah, this is pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and please do respect my opinion on this thing. And if you have like your own opinion, then be sure to leave it in the comments. But yeah, this is pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did enjoy, then be sure to leave a like, subscribe, and see you guys next episode. Adios.